Welcome to the PyAF1 online course. We'll learn about building assets in PyAF. Now AF, or the Asset Framework, is an organizational layer that works in conjunction with the PyData Archive to combine the time series data from the data archive with data from calculations and external relational sources to create one central system of record for all of your asset data. And as the name Asset Framework implies, we can organize data around assets and then group assets into hierarchical models, with the end result being that users can much more easily find the data they need for their analyses and everyday decision making. So let's take a look at one of these structures and see how this might be helpful in some of the benefits of using AF. Here we have a model for the HVAC system of the OSIsoft Research Lab. As we can see, the research lab has been divided into three HVAC zones, and each zone has a blower, a chiller, and a heater. So we've organized our assets into different areas, i.e. the zones, and all those are grouped under one main parent element called the OSIsoft Research Lab. As I mentioned, we can group all the data for a particular asset around that asset. So here we have things like real-time data from the PyData Archive, metadata coming from an external database, and calculated data. Now, as an additional organizational tool, we can also categorize attributes, making them much easier to find. So now I've gone and grouped all of my metadata under one category called nameplate, and all of my tag data under another category called real-time data. Additionally, with templatization in AF, we can make sure we have a standard set of attributes for each type of asset class. So for example, if I go to zone 2 and look at the blower there, we see that it has the exact same set of attributes that blower 1 had, i.e. we have a consistent naming convention. Equipment code for one is also called equipment code for the other. And we also have consistent units of measure. So voltage rating is always in volts for blower one. And the same is true for blower two. This is in contrast to a traditional data archive, where if I wanted to find the same data for different blowers, I might have to go to the server and search for the various tags that I need. As you can see, oftentimes the tag naming convention isn't always that friendly to humans. And additionally, units of measure and descriptions for various variables are not always consistent in the data archive server. So AF is giving us a far superior organizational tool for grouping data and making it easier to find. AF functionality has also been integrated into all of our client tools. So for example, if I was given the task of developing some monitoring displays for our zones, previously I would have to go in, build a display for each zone, and map all the tags. Here, with the AF integration, I can just create an element relative display. And here's another nice feature of AF. It does automatic unit conversions. So even though my two temperatures here are in degree F in the database, on the client side, I can choose any temperature I want. So let's go with Celsius here. Click OK, OK, and now I immediately have a trend of my indoor temperature and thermostat setting. And you can see that they're using degrees C. And we can also see that due to the AF integration, I can quickly switch between zones and the data is updated depending on which zone I've selected. So now, in about a minute or two, I've been able to build a display that allows me to monitor the temperatures for all three zones, whereas previously I would have needed three different displays or three different trends to be able to look at all of the zones. Also, AF integration is built into DataLink. I built a report for the zones that shows me the indoor temperature and the temperature offset. We have current values and also the daily averages over the last week. And I can quickly switch between zones here by just selecting the proper zone from the drop-down box. This is all built quite easily because of the AF search tools built into DataLink. AF integration is also built into our web-based client tools, CoreSite and WebParts. So let's go ahead and proceed with the class, and you can see how to build these back-end structures into AF and greatly enhance the user experience within your client tools.